We're gonna do a gym today that involves sprinting. Now, it doesn't have to. You can replace the sprinting with crawling or carrying something, whatever. We're just covering distance. But today I'm gonna introduce the idea of coloring distance or covering distance with speed on your feet, fast. It's a little different than, say, jogging. And oftentimes when I see people doing sprint combos where they do something and then sprint, it turns into sort of a slog. It's not really a sprint. It becomes a jog. So our goal is to try to keep it a sprint. Keep it fast on the feet, quick acceleration. That's the big goal, the quick acceleration. If it slows down a little bit after the acceleration, that's fine. But our goal is to explode out of the beginning, just pop out of that start position and go, go, go. Try to get as much force development in the quickest period of time as we can. And how are we gonna do that? Well, it's gonna require us using a lot of leg power and a lot of booty power, but also a lot of hip flexor power. So we're gonna prepare for this by getting the legs ready and the booty ready, but also the hip flexors. They play a huge role in this because not only are you driving off the leg using the booty and the leg, but then you have to pull the leg back up very quickly, which is why it differs so much from, say, jogging. Your foot is trying to spend as little time on the ground as possible while also developing as much force during that little bit of time. So here's how we're gonna get ready for it. In fact, I'm gonna have Dave join me. Dave is not what you'd call a sprinter. These are his words, not mine. We're gonna see if we can turn him into one today.
Sprinting's hard.
Dave's done more middle distance running and long distance running than I have. He's done 5Ks and stuff. And you used to jog regularly.
Yeah.
More so than I ever have. Whereas I like to go from point A to point B very quick and get it over with. You can develop so much power within that short period of time that it has huge benefit, huge crossover to other things. Unlike, well, say, jogging, which doesn't have a ton of crossover to much else. If you're gonna be a jogger, if you're gonna be a runner, and you're doing long distances, you're getting good at doing long distances, but it doesn't necessarily help a lot of your other skills. Meanwhile, sprinting has huge crossover to everything else. So that's why we're gonna just introduce it here and see what you think. And by no means am I an expert track athlete. I have learned from quite a few really good track athletes, and I like to apply the techniques I know, and I think I can generate a fair amount of speed. But we're gonna call this the practical person's guide to sprinting. You're not trying to win any competitions, you're just trying to go from point A to point B very fast. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna cover a little bit of ground, and you don't have to, you can actually do this in place, but I like to do it covering a little bit of ground by taking a leg up as straight as I can forward and as straight as I can back, and then placing it forward and doing the next leg forward and back. Now again, you can do this in place. I could just simply lift, lift, step, lift, lift, step, but I like to cover some ground with it. So I'm going to, no, you have to get back here so you look smaller.
Okay.
What's gonna happen, and by the way, the goal here is leg as straight as possible. In other words, it's really tempting to do this and have that knee bend in both directions. In fact, when the leg goes back here, it's very possible that you're gonna flip it up like that. So we're gonna try to keep the leg straight. In fact, my little cue for that, and it doesn't work for everybody, but my cue is straight toes. Point the toes like a ballerina. And then I step, swing, swing, step, swing, swing, step. Of course, the leg behind you is not gonna go near as high as the leg in front of you, and that's fine, but you're trying to open your hamstrings, hip flexors, step. Hamstrings, hip flexors, step. Hamstrings, hip flexors, step. And since we have balance challenge Dave over here, we'll see how all this works out. Now, what I do is I cover a certain amount of distance doing that, and on the way back, I change it up. If you remember the compass we did in a previous video, this is a walking version of the compass.
What?
I start by hinging, and as I hinge, that leg goes up. Again, as high as you can by keeping both legs straight, then I bring that leg around, and then I put it down as I hinge into the next one. So it has a little rhythm to it. Around. Hinge, both legs staying straight. Again, go as high as you can with a straight leg. If it bends, you're too high. And if you have someone else doing it with you, See how distracting you can be to them. When I practice this on my own, I like to cover a good 40 to 50, 60 feet doing this back and forth. So I'll do the straight leg up and back quite a ways, turn around, do this half compass on the way back, and then I'll cover both forward and back doing the next thing, which is a skip. It's a good old-fashioned skip. Now, if you haven't skipped since you were 8 years old, we're gonna turn it into something a little more explosive than what you might be used to. But the big goals, okay, that was actually pretty cute. The big goals, as the knee comes up, the opposite elbow comes up. This is important. One of the biggest things about sprinting that differs it from just going out for a jog is the arms play a huge role. The arms help drive the hips. And so as this arm comes up, the opposite elbow comes up. Now, if you're an adult who hasn't skipped in many years, the chances are you're gonna go same arm and leg first. And then you're gonna stop yourself and realize that's wrong. Don't worry, still to this day, I have to sometimes check myself. Okay, opposite arm and leg. So as this elbow pulls up, boom, my knee is gonna explosively pull up. So two things are happening. I have an explosive pull with this leg, and I have an explosive pop with the leg that's staying straight. It's popping me off the ground. Now you can actually do this in place, pop, pop. But we're gonna cover some distance. In fact, I'll start way back here, and I'll pop, 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 pop. And I'll come back. A little bit of hang time.
Hang time, hang time, hang time.
The big goal here is to explode so much that you get that little bit of hang time. And what that's doing is that's keeping your time on the ground to a minimum. You're popping off the ground. Pop, pop, pop. So eventually, this skip will actually get faster. And there's nothing wrong with doing several laps of this skip. So long-term goal, pop, 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 pop. I know you want to see Dave do that with me. Here we go. Pop, pop, pop. By the way, I recommend skipping often. Yes, there's a little bit of playfulness to it. In fact, there's a lot of playfulness to it, but there's also a lot of athleticism to it. Practice your skip. It leads to a better sprint, believe it or not. If you were to freeze frame a sprinter, they often look like they're in a skip. Imagine you're trying to pop off the ground as fast as you can while creating as little turnaround time on the ground as you can. You're not spending a lot of time on the ground. So if you find yourself skipping, ga-boom, 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 then work on pop. As soon as you get there, pop again. Switch those feet as fast as you can. So it's a turnaround pop, because that is gonna be your sprint eventually. Those are some real basic drills for now. There are some more advanced drills you can play with to get better at sprinting. So if it's something you wanna get into more, which I recommend, then you can look into a much deeper warm-up session, where you can add all sorts of interesting turnarounds and drop drills and speed drills just to get your hips and your legs and your hip flexors ready for that quick turnaround on the ground as explosive as possible. So what if we took that sprint and we added something really simple? Now the big goal here is acceleration. We're trying to come out of whatever it is we're doing as fast as we can. We're not trying to cover that entire distance as fast as we can. We're just trying to accelerate for now. You can sprint distance for time at another time, but for now, we're trying to do something and then explode out of it. If you start your sprint angled and then eventually straighten out, that's when you know you've got a good acceleration. You accelerate angled and then eventually you straighten out. If you've pushed a prowler, if you've pushed a sled, that's similar to that angle that you want. That's the beauty of a prowler, is to get that explosion out of the beginning of a sprint. It's also great because it mimics going uphill or pushing something really heavy. Both of those are awesome too. But you can use the prowler to increase your sprint performance and your sprint mechanics by going quick, not a super heavy sled, but quick on your toes at that angle. Never worry about straightening out. You're just trying to build that power of acceleration. So we love our sleds. We love them for many reasons, but out here, often, we don't have one, so let's just sprint. So, we're gonna do a little combo involving the sprint. This is as simple as it gets, but as you know, simple is never synonymous with easy. First, I know you're probably sick of them at this point, but we're gonna do burpees. Now, when's the last time in any of these videos I just did a straight up burpee? It's been a long time. Today is a good chance because the sprint is gonna take a ton out of us. So mentally, I don't wanna have to overthink anything. We're gonna keep it really simple. But here's the beauty of this template. You can do it with anything. If you have equipment, you can do kettlebell swings or squat jumps or anything. Anything on one side of a distance, sprint to the other side, do something else, sprint back. The world's simplest template. Eventually, it's gonna be 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So what it's gonna look like is a handful of burpees, then we go that way. Well, Dave's coming this way. And we do the next number down, sprint, next number down. Remember, the burpees are always going to be a beautiful squat into a beautiful plank. They don't have to be fast to be really effective. In fact, if they're fast and sloppy, get rid of them. Take them out of your template. They're worthless. If they're fast and beautiful, awesome. No floppies, no squirmies. Beautiful squat, beautiful plank. If there's a push-up and a jump, that's optional, but it's awesome. So we're gonna do 5 wonderful burpees. Sprint 4, sprint 3. You don't have to watch the whole thing, but that's the idea. Our burpees are gonna be beautiful. Then the big goal is to come out of that last burpee as fast as we can. Now, the entire sprint might not be an acceleration, but the goal is to accelerate initially from that last burpee. Then we have to slow down a bit to get to the next part where we do the next section of burpees, and then we accelerate out of that. But the goal is to make that acceleration out of that last burpee as fast as possible. Hopefully by the halfway point, we might even be decelerating by then. Decelerating from a full sprint, not an easy task. Decelerate into a nice controlled slow and then stop. So here we go. Sweating bullets. Jesus, I haven't even lifted a leg yet. Imagine you're trying to pop off this.